Hey everyone, I'm Nog and welcome back to Satisfactory. I've finished up the motor production line here, so let's just take a quick look at that. We have the stators coming in here. We set them all up in the last episode to be produced, and they're now coming in and going on this line. We have set up rotor production here. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4 machines, 2 for screws and 2 for iron rods, and they are going in and becoming rotors over here at approximately 10 a minute, 10.02 a minute in total, which is fine, which meant that we needed to overclock the screws a little bit, so 22% and 24%. And over here we have overclocked the iron rods by 1% in order to meet the requirements from this thing. So yeah, 1 stupid percent, but it is what it is. But this one is producing at 5 per minute, 100% efficiency. And the next task is going to be to get our products out and into our storage facility. So we actually have more products than we have capacity here, because we only have 3 storage lines left, and we have steel beams, steel pipes, stators and motors that we want to get out. So we need to, one of the products is going to have to go up to the next level of storage, and that's okay. But first things first, let's get the steel beams and steel pipes out, and then get the stators out as well, and it will all go down to these 3 last lines down at the end. But how are we going to get them down there? That is the big problem. So I think what we're going to do is we are going to pull this out here and make as sharp a turn as we can. Encroaching others' clearance, and that's its own clearance. Its own machine's clearance, for some reason. It doesn't like that, but we can do like that, and now we're not encroaching. So we want to come over, and I think this one is going to be down at the end. So let's just see, can we get this thing out? Can barely. Please don't encroach. See, logistics. Come on. No, not there. There. Alright, and then we want the last one to come out as well, and it'll go straight into there. Alright, so we have beams, pipes, and stators. Stators are going to be on the first one, then beams, and then pipes, I think. But what we're going to do is, we are going to get stackable pole here and stack it 3 high, and we're going to do the same here. Is that right? Yeah, that's right. There, and then we just need to get these lines onto that somehow. So beams can come in this way, I'm thinking. And go onto the top one. Can't go onto the top one. Dang it. That means that we need to get them up sooner. This one, it can go into the bottom one. It's just the one of them that we need to get in sooner, or we need to move these down a little bit. Let's try it here instead. See if that works. It actually does. So we're going to need steel beams way more often and pipes way more often than we need stators. So let's do like this. Come on. And it's gonna go straight into that. I don't like that. So what we're going to do is bring it over like this and then get it going under. Which means that the floor is too steep, which drives me absolutely bonkers. It's not too steep when you just place this down. It's only when you're placing it down together with the belt. Some obscure reason. Okay, that should be enough to get this down to number 2. And then we can get the stators going here. Let's just stick a thing there. And where do we want this? We want it there, I think. Nope. It's one too far. Go there. That was one too short. I'm gonna live with it for now. And get you going up to number 2. And then we just need you going up to number 3. And I actually think we need to put a hole here so it doesn't go straight into the gate, go straight through the other stackable thing. Alright. So now we can get this going down here. And we can get the beams going in there. Actually, what we could do is, and what we will do is, or will we? No, we won't. So let's build this again. So I was thinking that we could put them on top here, but it's gonna be a little bit too messy, I think, if we do that. So let's just keep it over here. But what we can do in order to make it look just a little bit nicer is take this out and move it out a little bit so it lines up. So let's see, 5 and there, right? Nope. There that it needs to be. Let's try it. Yes, it is. Alright. And let's do the same over here. There. And get that going in. And the last one. There. Alright. So, Faders, you go in here. Can't afford, what are we missing? Steel, iron, what are they called? Rods? Iron rods? What we are missing? So where do we have those? I think it's here. No, that's screws. There we have rods. Alright, we have some rods. How full is this one? Not at all. So, there's still some production to be done before we're full up on those. Alright. So, let's get these over here. And down there. And let's get the beams. Going in there. Alright. So we have those running as well. Very nice. And they are coming in and being stored once they arrive. Here come the pipes. And the beams are coming as well. Excellent. Alright. So we have filled up the bottom storage area, and we actually need to build up and get a second level storage, which I think we will do. I think we'll make these a little bit higher. Let's get the walls and stick those on zero, because what I think I will do, let's go up top here and do it. I think I will put a half floor here, and then I will make it a second story. This. And close here. We do not have enough materials to build everything, that's for sure. We're gonna need more concrete. We have concrete not too far away. Whoops. It was just to go get it. Out of concrete. And we could use some iron plates as well. We have a ton of concrete here, which we also need to get set up. On the real factory, instead of just having it out there in the middle of nowhere. But right now, it's all about storage. So let's grab some iron plate. We don't want the iron ingots on us. I'll just stick them in there for now. Like that. Alright. So, yeah, that's how it's gonna be. I don't know. We need to do some kind of decoration thing on the buildings as well, because just big square blocks is not very interesting. So we'll probably have to do that. Or maybe I'll do that when I start a new series. I have an idea for another Satisfactory series. that I'm toying with, which I'll start up as soon as we're done with this one. And this one will finish as soon as we have everything producing, basically. So, yeah. All right. This is going, and we are getting steel beams, a little bit anyway. And that's because we need the Mark III belts everywhere, so that's something that I will go around doing in between episodes as well. But right now, let's see. Let's just put a regular wall here. And a door there. And then we need some walkways somewhere. Where is there? Walkway straight. Invalid aim location. Okay. How's that possible? Oh, we don't. We need a floor, I guess. So let's just put in a foundation. Let's just put it on 7. We don't need splitters and mergers and stuff right now. So there. And walkway, great. Can it go on now? No. Alright. Won't it go on? There it will. Alright. Well, that was a bit weird. Walls. Regular wall. That. And door center there. All right. Then we just need to get up there somehow, which is not the biggest of problems. We'll just put this on here. This is not the prettiest thing in the world, but it doesn't need to be right now. Here comes the truck. Or the tractor, there it goes. Alright, so let's get these foundations going. I think I'll leave this one foundation not done. I might have an idea. Just need to fill all this up. Wonder if we have enough concrete for that. I am kind of doubting it, actually. Alright. Oh, we have enough. We just need some storage chests, and we will just use regular ones because we're not able to make everything that the other ones need. So there. Floor is too steep. Well, that means that we do need to make foundations all the way, at least for now. We can take them out later if you want to. Container. There. 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 And you get the idea, so that's how it's going to be all the way. There, I think. Yeah. So it's basically a copy of the bottom floor. Again, with 11 storage containers. I don't know if we actually need that many. I don't know if that there are that many products left to produce, but we'll set it up no matter what. And there we go. And then we need walls all the way and so on, but you get the idea, so that's what it's gonna look like. So yeah, and then we can we just get some walls going here like that. And then we'll set up outputs like this. But we don't need that many down here. I think we need 2, maybe 3 outputs from the bottom floor. Because then we'll move up, build above this floor, go up, and start building on the second floor of this building. Because we don't have room for making encased beams and concrete and everything down here. So we have motors that we need to get out. I want to set up, I think I'll set up concrete and biomass production down here as well. So that's 3 outputs, and then the rest will be from the next floor, which I think is going to be okay. So yeah. That's what's gonna happen, but I think it's looking decent. I think it's looking decent, and if we get up top on our viewing platform up there, which I want to do, then I think it'll look quite good actually. So how much of power are we using? Around 200, just over 200 megawatts. Which isn't too bad, but I'm guessing it's because there are a lot of machines that are not going because they're not getting the materials they need because we don't have Mach 3 belts up and running yet. But we will have that very soon. I think I'll do it, I'll go around upgrading all of them in between this episode and the next one. But let's just take a look up here. I think that looks like a factory. I think that looks like a factory. That looks pretty darn good. And over here we have all the smelting, which also needs to be fixed up. I'm fully aware of that. But I think that looks pretty good as well. Oh yeah, I am overall quite happy with the look of things. But that's going to be it for this episode, guys. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you enjoyed it, and I'll see you next time.